Hello, my name's Denise Turner, and along with Gerry Bennison, Claudia Megele and Leanne Fenge, I'm one of the guest editors for this special edition of Social Work Education, the International Journal, on social media and social work. We live in a rapidly changing landscape of social networking and digital technology, and this special edition represents a moment in time for social work's relationship with social media. We've called the special edition Social Work and Social Media, Best Friends or Natural Enemies, as we believe this encapsulates the threats that social media can bring to a profession that's so concerned with confidentiality and protecting the vulnerable. Social networking platforms dissolve boundaries between the person and the professional in ways that challenge traditional social work values. Yet, social networking also brings untold new opportunities for changing power relationships and reaching out to previously deprived groups. As guest editors, we all bring our personal experiences of positive involvement with social networking. And while we are mindful of the challenges, we hope that this special edition will help readers to embrace all the possibilities offered by social media to social work. At a recent annual board meeting of Social Work Education, some of the board members offered their views on the debate around the threats and opportunities which social media brings to social work.
It's a good question, not such an easy one to answer.
No.
Because it's new, there's lots of new ideas around. I think it's interesting to see some of the pilot projects in recent years using apps in practice environments, happening to the field of practice, looking at use of Twitter, Facebook, looking at the challenges for monitoring those platforms in terms of appropriate use and the ethics. That's useful, but also for actually thinking about service users and carers as well, development of projects, keeping the focus on positive, constructive use of social media is perhaps the way forward.
See, because my initial reaction to it is that's really unethical to do that, because lots of people that we work with talk about that heightened surveillance. You know, I remember there was an interview with a group of young mothers talking about so incredibly worried if one of their children does something wrong in school, even though all children do that, because for them the consequences were greater because there's this kind of heightened surveillance. So, you know, there is a really unethical feel to all of that. But then I remember a social worker saying to me, what if a child's life is in danger?
Yeah.
It's acceptable then. So are these things absolute or
it's very
blurred, lines, aren't there, between demarcations of what's acceptable and unacceptable practice, what's ethical and what's unethical practice. But I think it's important that we have these debates.
You also need to, there's a really good opportunity here, I think, to use social media to move beyond what has in the past been rhetoric in literature to actually providing types of all forms of evidence to actually promote issues or involvement in education, but also practice developments and service developments, particularly on service user and care involvement.
I think it's both an opportunity and a threat. It's an opportunity in terms of being able to get information out to the wider range of people in different formats and different ways to make it give them opportunity to understand in different ways. It's also a threat in terms of once the information's out, you can't take it back, and what you put up and being clear about what the risks are, particularly in the future of other people seeing that, and that how that may reflect on your professional being professional. But I think it's about how do you manage that but still grasp the opportunities. So I think we need to go beyond the written word.
Good practice globally, and enabling conversations to open up in a much more global context about key social work themes. And there's a real sort of seesaw there, isn't there? Because it's not all one thing, it's not all bad, and it's not all good.
My my view is, I agree with both of you when you said it is an opportunity and threat, and it's up to us social workers, how do we make these threats into opportunities? I think social work is all about that. And coming from Asia, South Asia, social media playing a big role, especially recent disasters in Nepal. The social media has been heavily used to raise funds, find people, you know, build alliances. So there is a big opportunity that I think social work should make use of it.
Preparing this special edition has been a privilege, and we hope that you enjoy reading it and that you find it useful for your work. Above all, we hope that this special edition will help to contribute to the lively debates about how social networking can be harnessed as a force for good within social work education and practice. Enjoy.